Welcome to episode 3 of King's Row 6. I'm yours, Lost Wolf. And last time we dug around and Naren grabbed a couple of things. We're gonna head on out from here. Most of today's episode is gonna take place on the Isle of Wonder because we want to get some stuff started there. We're not gonna finish the Isle of Wonder, but we're gonna get a fair bit of the way through it. So, like the shopkeep said, we need to be near water whenever we want to use the magic map. This is as good a place as any. We grab our map. And Alexander pulls out his magic map. So, okay, what we have here is we got like a quick travel system. This is where we are, the Isle of the Crown. There's the Isle of Wonder over there, the Isle of the Sacred Mountain, and the Isle of the Beast. We're gonna head to the Isle of the Sacred Mountain very quickly. Alexander feels a strange pulling sensation. I always loved that little animation of how it looked like everything came to life the minute you clicked on an island. Okay, so we're not going to go up here. You can go up here, but we're not going to do that today. We've got a flower over here. There's an ugly flower going near the base of the cliff. We want that. Alexander picks the flowers and is startled by its hideously strong skunk-like odor. For a moment, he can smell nothing else. And there's a feather over here, which we'd like. Alexander takes the feather. Now, we are out of King's Quest, out of Police Quest and Space Quest land, so things have proper descriptions again. Colors of flames burst from the center of the incredibly stinky flower and drip onto its petals. The flower's appearance is as flamboyant as its smell. Alexander is carrying an unusually large black feather. And so with that, we can actually head off from here to the Isle of Wonder. Okay, so there's a little object in the sea over here, but you gotta be careful if you go kind of past this line here that I'm drawing, you'll get swept away by the currents. So what you kind of want to do is you want to wait for that guy to come as close as you can get him, and then you're going to go in and wade and offer him and go and grab that. So while we wait for that to happen, because it might take a little while, we're going to talk to this guy over here. Hey, why aren't you asleep like the other oysters?
I'm so weary, but I can't sleep. I have a terrible ache in my mouth.
So, clearly, if it's an oyster, probably there's a pearl in his mouth, and that's keeping him from being asleep. So, first, let's go grab that. Because it's come to a point where we can get it. Alexander picks up the object floating in the water. It appears to be a string of letters. They say, "Where are you going?" Alexander decides to keep that sentence, even though it is incomplete. And, of course, again, if you go and you look at the sentence, there we go. Oddly enough, a sentence that says, "Where are you going?" If we now, because remember we have the boring book. If we read the boring book to the oyster. "If you're having trouble sleeping, perhaps you'd like me to read to you."
"Oh, hey, that'd be great."
"Two dulcimers raised to the degree of 40 half dulcimers, divided into equal parts by the third of a cackle of grouse geese, put over the result of 10 fine mackerels, albeit small fine mackerels, stretched over the total of 53 and an eighth bottles of wildebeest lard." Now you'll notice that as I read him, his mouth goes open and shut. And in those spaces where his mouth goes open and shut, we need to go and grab the pearl out of his mouth. "Yields a gilded minnow of precise measurements, 2,069 centrals by 3,023.67 pounds. Not punts, as might be expected. This is not to say, however, in any sense whatsoever, that deviations in mean temperature of 5 or 6 degrees or so, and grab. Exotic makes a grab for the pool. Hey, you fixed my mouth. It feels great. Our little oyster drifts into peaceful slumber with the rest of his oyster friends. And now we're going to do the most disturbing thing. My god. Alexander hears someone coming. By fierce gods of the isle we be. Watch for a man, said he, with ears and nose, tongue, hands and eyes. Its nature cannot be disguised. If man it be, then man it dies. So what we got here is got 5 gnomes, and each gnome has a specific scent. You can see in the front there, this guy's got a big giant nose, so he's gonna smell. And it'll go down the line in exactly that fashion. We got 5 senses. We need to appease the 5 senses of the gnomes. Old Tom Trowel, smell your smell. Do that which you do so well. And when they're doing that, you only have a very finite amount of time to get your item ready and to give it to them. So this is the stinky flower. Alexander holds the flower stench up to the gnome with the jumbo nose. Tom Trowel I am, that's all I'll be. My nose knows all on land and sea. A flower of stenches washed ashore. A flower to soul and nothing more. Listen, hark you, Gorvina. Do your duty as you swore. With your ears, please tell us more. Okay, and he's got a giant set of ears, so we're going to appease his hearing by giving him a nightingale to listen to. Alexander winds the tin nightingale and plays it for the gnome with her monumental ears. There is something worrisome about this puzzle, though. If he has monumental ears and he can hear everything, surely you should be hearing the nightingale being wound up. A nose is not a way to spy. My ears cannot be told a lie. A nightingale is all there'll be. No man is near, and so say me. Taste, Grumfrump, that which we might know, whether friend or whether foe. So we need to get him the mint. Now this looks confusing at first, but that's the pull. This is the mint. And the other thing is you can't touch it, because if you do, then it will melt, so you have to actually use the pointer. It's a very weird distinction to be making this late in the game. Alexander holds the mint out for the gnome with a gigantic mouth. Ew. Creepy. Grumfrump knows a tasty treat. It matters not what others bleat. No danger is this one so sweet. Trilly-dilly, use your hands. Is it beast or is it man? Okay, and for this guy, we want him to feel the rabbit's foot. Alexander holds the rabbit's foot out for the gnome with the huge hands. Be all you mad, what aileth thee? A bunny can't troll merrily. A hare does not at all taste sweet. A rabbit here is all we greet. All ball batter, never fatter. Vision can resolve this matter. Look you now, and end this chatter. That's funny, because this guy's probably the fattest of the lot. This guy or that guy, maybe. Or even this guy. He's not fat at all. Okay, so we have invisible ink, which we're going to pour on ourselves. Alexander pulls the contents of the empty looking ink bottle over himself. By all that's beauteous, fair, and sightly, for morns I sleep with nightly. Yeah, we won't ask about that. There's nothing here at all, I say. Enough of this, let's now away! That's also pretty creepy. Little drawing that. And off they go. Alexander did it. He's fooled the guards. We're going to head this away quickly. We're just meeting all the people of the Isle of Wonder, really, and that's what we're doing today. There's a spider here, don't mess with the spider. There's a book there, we can grab the book, but not really. What do you think you're doing? I'm sorry, I didn't realize this book had an owner. I'm in need of a rare book. No owner? All books have owners. My good man. And this book, owner bookworm to you. Oh, sorry. Bookworm to you. Wouldn't part with one of his books for anything. Isn't there something I can do for you to pay for the book? Let's see. Do you have an itinerant clause? No clause at all, I'm afraid. As an exception, you always should. Oh. Don't mind oxymoron and diphthong. They're fairly limited grammatical principles, you know. Let's see. A marsh pig that does taxes? No, I'm afraid not. A dangling participle? I'm fresh out. A purple fiddle whacker? No, I don't think so. Sorry. An idiosyncrasy, perhaps? Afraid not. Then what good are you? So you have to come back when you've got something that will satisfy the bookworm. We don't have that one yet, so we're not going to get involved in that. What we are going to do is head north. Oh boy. Okay, so this area here is the swamp. We will meet the things in the swamp later, but for right now, we just keep moving this away. Because there are things in the swamp, believe you me. Wow. This year's got one of my favorite bits of music in the game, but we'll have to wait for a while before we can get to that point. Because it's the Isle of Wonder, there's lots of weird places for you to go to. This is one of them. Can't go very far into it. Checkmate. Only chess pieces allowed in chessboard land. That's right. Humans aren't allowed in, and never will be. Stay out. Of course, if we've got, you know, chess pieces, we got the two knights here. We're gonna have the two queens. And the two queens are gonna have a weird discussion. I must insist, Your Highness. I shall send a lump of coal to the vizier and the princess as a present for their wedding, and that's the end of it. And I suppose you'll leave me with only the stupid soiled egg to send, Your Highness. I want to impress the new king and queen of the realm as much as you do. As queen of this island, I have every right to that lump of coal. Who isn't queen of this isle? The lump of coal is in my possession. Therefore, I shall do as I please with it. Besides, there's nothing wrong with that spoiled egg. The egg, though delightfully spoiled, is not nearly so valuable as a lump of coal, and you know it. Your Highness always got to carry the singing stone. It's not fair that you get the coal, too. That doesn't count. The singing stone was stolen by that horrid beast. I should get to keep the coal just because my stone was stolen. It wasn't your stone.
It belonged to the Isle of Wonder Treasury. Your Highness always thinks that everything is hers.
Excuse me, my good man, but could you settle an argument for us?
Which of us should get to carry the coal and which the egg? Remember, white is the color of deserving truth and virtue.
Be quiet, Your Highness, and let him make up his own mind. I, for one, shall be more proper, and not even mention the fact that red is the color of love.
I'm sorry, Your Majesties, I am partial to both red and white, but I'm afraid that I don't know how to solve your problem. One of you will just have to be gracious and allow the other the lump of coal.
What a ridiculously stupid idea.
Quite ludicrous.
Well, he was a lot of help, wasn't he?
Yes, obviously a man of high intelligence.
And off they go.
The lump of coal goes much better with my gown anyway. Black and red are imperial colors.
That's the silliest thing I ever heard. Red does not go with anything. Being much too self-conscious, white is the perfect accompaniment to any color.
Oh dear.
Okay, so we have control again. One thing to note, though, is that they're talking about a singing stone that they had in their possession, and that the beast on Beast Isle, the Isle of the Beast, stole that. And we've seen a little bit of that in the past, where the ferryman told us that a lot of these isles had problems because they had ownership of things that seemed to have fallen into the wrong hands. So each isle has something that has been taken from them, and in this case, it's the singing stone that they had, and that is now obviously all evidently on the Isle of the Beast.
Let's go grab a scarf. Alexander picks up the Red Queen's scarf.
He is not actually going to give it back to her, by the way.
goodness. The scarf is made of red silk.
We may not be in Police Quest or Space Quest anymore, but sometimes the descriptions are very Spartan.
Okay. Is that lettuce growing in the garden? It looks a little chilled.
Why, it must be iceberg lettuce. So we're going to go grab some iceberg lettuce. Alexander picks a head of iceberg lettuce.
Egads, is that cold?
And of course you can look at the iceberg lettuce. Alexander's carrying a full head of a new queer looking lettuce made of ice. Lettuce is rapidly melting.
Okay, so one of the things to set up is that you need to move and move.
And next week, what we will do, in fact, is we will use almost immediately the iceberg lettuce because we have got a job to do on the Isle of the Beast. Anyhow, I am Lost Wolf. I'm going to pause so that the iceberg lettuce doesn't melt more. I'm Lost Wolf. Thank you so much for watching. This has been King's Quest Episode 3. King's Quest 6, to be exact. Episode 3. Thank you for joining me. I shall see you all next week where we go to the Isle of the Beast. Have a great week, folks, and goodbye for now.